Meanwhile, it's been a trying day for many as they battled the massive clean-up without electricity. Ruined food and medicines among possessions destined for the tip as the damage bill mounts.
Roofs under repair and a day spent cleaning up. Homeowners across the state are counting the cost of gale-force winds for a second night running. The northeast suburbs are among the hardest hit. Eltham neighbours sharing stories of damage and blackouts.
Well, haven't had a shower, no lights all night, no food sort of, can't cook, the stove's not working.
Others came home to heartache.
It was absolute carnage, there was trees down everywhere and the power was out when we got home and I saw the devastation next door and I just couldn't believe it.
Yeah, last night was a bit unnerving. I wasn't in the area yesterday when the damage happened, but you could hear it whistling through, so you never know what's coming next.
Bin's the only place for wasted food.
Lost all the stuff in the freezer and refrigeration, you know, all that's gone out.
Businesses are also feeling the effects.
Medicines have to be kept fresh, perfect, and when the fridge isn't working, then we have to destroy it.
Supplier ASP AusNet has asked other providers to help get its customers reconnected, and the SES volunteers haven't stopped. With 2,000 trees down across the state and 3,000 calls for help.
We've had close to 1,000 volunteers out in the field. We've had over 300 out there working today.
It's all been roof damage.
Yep.
It all has been preventable if there'd been a bit of preventive maintenance done beforehand.
Many residents blame councils for not removing dangerous trees.
That we were literally waiting for this to happen, and it did.
And the damaged power lines cause more heartache for commuters. Services on the Hurstbridge line went down yesterday afternoon. Buses have been ferrying passengers for most of the day.
And now our reporter Rory McLaren joins us live from the main street of Eltham. Rory, has power been restored yet?
Mal, after a day of disruptions, slowly but surely power is returning here in Eltham. A short time ago, I spoke to power supplier SP AusNet, who told me that 880 customers in Eltham and Eltham North remain without power. Now, it's obviously a very small percentage of almost 10,000 customers around the state who are currently powerless. Now, at this stage, the outages are taking some time to clear, and here in Eltham, that's due to a high voltage line which has been brought down. Now, SP AusNet is warning that these repairs may take a little longer than they first expected to get back up and going, but they're hopeful that all of their customers without power should be back or may be back online by this evening, but they're also urging people to prepare for the worst eventuality, which is another night in the dark. And up here in Eltham, the wind is slowly starting to pick up and it looks like we might have some more wild weather on the way. With more is Mike Larkin, who's with some of those very hard-working SES volunteers in Malvern East. Mike, what have you got for us?
Yeah, thank you, Rory, and a very good evening. You can see the crew behind me working on this roof. They've been here for a number of hours now, and they'll still be here for a while this evening. Well, the winds here have started to ease off after reaching close to 100 kilometres per hour earlier today, well into the hundreds southeast of Melbourne. But be warned, the winds are coming. They're coming back as a front moves through western Victoria. In fact, in Melbourne, we can expect the wind to gust to 80 kilometres per hour later tonight, closer to midnight. And then tomorrow, as winds change direction from the northwest to west, the wind could reach 80 to 100 kilometres per hour in Melbourne. Of course, a severe weather warning remains in place both tonight and tomorrow, and always a concern when the wind changes direction and showers are also forecast overnight and tomorrow. More details a little later in the news. Back to the studio.
Right, thanks to Mike Larkin in Malvern East and reporter Rory McLaren at Eltham.